Dart champions Marcel Aiken of Belchertown and Al Drosefiak of Chicopee on Candlepin Super Bowl. Hi everyone, I'm Brian Leary. Well, I guess we got a lot of angles here. Marcel Aiken and Al Drosefiak back for their second week. This is the sixth week of our series, so they've still got a shot at winning for four consecutive weeks. No, let's make that, this is the seventh week of the series. They can still win 4 weeks, although not in this series. I'm just gonna make things more difficult, I think, if I can continue on. But the angles I was talking about, Carol Tack is a former winner here in a roll-off. Bob Bergman, last time bowled against Marcel Aiken and lost to her, so we've got all kinds of connections, and why don't we just get right on to the bowling. It's worth $200 to win the preliminary round, $100 to the losers, $250 for the championship round, and $100 to the losers likewise. So let's get to the prelims. Carol and Marlo. Barbara will bowl our first frame for us. Oh, thanks. Carol Tack from Kent. She's married with one child. She bowls at Empire Lanes. And Barbara Marlowe of Mattapan bowls at Sammy White. She's married with a couple of children.
Oh.
Carol won here about 5 years ago, I think it was. She and Gene Gates in a roll-off. Marcel Aiken, of course, is a two-time winner here, so let's get people familiar with our prize schedule. One frame down, a 9 and an 8 on the other side. Bob Bergman and Ray McGurk will see what they can do on top of that when they come back with their first frames in just a couple of minutes.
If you've been looking for a great new restaurant to try, I've got just the ticket for you. I think you'll really enjoy the clubhouse dining room of Wonderland. Who knows, it may become one of your favorites. And here at Wonderland last year, over $123 million was paid out to the fans in winnings. We've just spent $5 million completely renovating Wonderland for your year-round comfort.
Play the favorite,
come on, come on.
Wonderland.
You got the uglies.
Huh?
Just look at your car. Rust, dents, chipped and peeling paint. You should take it to Mako. With expert bodywork and a new paint job, Mako will make your car beautiful, restoring its sleek finish and shining colors.
Ooh, handsome.
Oh, really?
Not you, your car. Get rid of the uglies. Drive into a Mako Auto Painting and Bodywork Center today.
Roger Staubach for Rolaids.
How do you spell relief?
R-O-L-A-I-D-S. I hate to admit it, but I eat a lot of greasy foods.
For acid indigestion, I spell it R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaids really does spell relief.
Like a sponge, Rolaids antacid medicine consumes 100% of the acid required to give millions 100% relief.
For millions of Americans, Rolaids spells 100% relief.
Enter the Rolaids Relief Man sweepstakes. Entry blanks at your local store.
At the Knoxville World's Fair, we lay this carpet to prove that Woolite self-cleaning rug cleaner with fiber pill keeps rugs cleaner longer. After the crowds dirtied the carpet, we cleaned it with fast, easy, no-scrub Woolite. Later, when the crowds dirtied the rug again, all it took was a vacuuming to get it clean. Because Woolite has fiber pill, which keeps rugs cleaner longer. So get Woolite self-cleaning rug cleaner with fiber pill. Makes rugs easy to clean, hard to dirty.
Now the man, Ray McGurk from East Boston. And Bob Bergman of Somerville, married with one on the way. Now each has just the two pins to pick up for a spare, but Ray McGurk definitely has the tougher lead. Bob Bergman, a little easier. But that doesn't go either. Now, Ray McGurk was last on with us about 5 years ago, and at the time, he was bowling with a broken finger. He just didn't want to pass up the opportunity to bowl on the show. So a couple of tens here in the second frame. And after That's you. Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman now are at 19. Ray McGurk and Carol Tagg at 18. And one more to go. Trying to get back to those angles I was alluding to at the top of the show, Carol Tack is a former winner.
I feel constantly guilty, and it doesn't matter which life you choose. It doesn't matter. If you work, you're going to feel guilty, and if you don't work, you're going to feel guilty.
Many people came in to talk to me, men and women.
Tack, a one-time winner, but she'd like to make it two times this time around. After three now, Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman are at 29, and Ray McGurk and Carol Tack are at 26. There they go. Bob Bergman with a strike in the fourth frame. Nine for Ray McGurk. So as it stands now through four, Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman are at 39 plus a couple, and Ray McGurk and Carol Tack are at 35. Barbara, of course, will have a couple of bonus balls to work with. And the diamond. First of two bonus balls. And an eight. But Barbara, remember, added eight onto the strike, so the lead after four was a dozen pins. Now after the eight and the 10 in the fifth frames, the lead is down to an even 10. There you see it, halfway through. Marks have been tough to come by. Couple of nines here in the sixth. So no change. The lead is still 10 pins for Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman. After six, it's 64 to 54. All right, here's a mark in the making. Depends on where that wood settles. The wood down here is a little wide of the pins. Let's see if she can carry it through. She does. Good spare. First one to Carol Tack and Ray McGurk. And there's another one, Barbara Marlowe. Well, that kind of explains why Barbara is a two-time winner here in the show. Ray McGurk adds five onto his spare. Bob Bergman adds them all. Strike on the spare. And that might go. A 10. So the reason for Ray McGurk's walking away with his head down is this scoreboard here. Just when he and Carol McGurk start to get hot, and the other team gets hotter. They're at 79 now, and Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman are at 94 plus a couple of throws. So here goes Carol Tack in frame number nine. Barbara Marlowe filling out the strike. Another one would be worth $50. Another mark here now would be worth $50. And there's a mark. Good shot, Carol Tack. A spare in the ninth, and Barbara Marlowe can't spare, so she can't pick up $50 in bonus money, which is given, as you well know, for three marks in a row. So let's see what we've got here. After eight complete, it's 103-79. Now the mark in the ninth changes that. Those eight pins on top of the mark help change that. So after nine, it's 112-97. And there's a mark. Ray McGurk is at 107 now. He'll wait for Bob Bergman to finish up. Bob's at 121, so there is nothing that Ray McGurk can do here to win it. A couple of pins. It didn't really matter how many he had, even if he had them all. A good, good finish for Ray McGurk and for Carol Tack, but unfortunately, it came a little bit too late. Had it started a couple of boxes earlier, it might have been a different story here. So, Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman will get to move off into our championship round as they finish up here with a string of 121. Carol Tack and Ray McGurk finish up with a 109, and there you see all the empty spaces up the top, and that's where it was settled. So Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman move off to take on Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak for all the marbles, and we'll be back with that in just a minute.
Hey, what you eating?
Quaker Corn Bran.
Oh,
Quaker Corn Bran.
What's bran?
I don't know, but I like it.
Hey, maybe bran's the stuff that makes it taste good.
I don't know.
Maybe there's bran in ice cream.
There must be bran in chocolate cake.
I don't know.
Quaker Corn Bran. Kids don't know why they like it, but they like it.
There's gotta be bran in lollipops. Mommy!
I was known as one of the meanest players in hockey. But I didn't deserve that, right?
Right.
I'm just a nice guy who comes in and has a few light beers from Miller with the boys. A pussycat who drinks light because it's less filling. And it tastes great. Really, if I was a nasty player, may a lightning bolt come down and strike this very spot.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer. And less.
Meineke Discount Mufflers shatters prices. Any make, any model. American cars, Japanese cars, German cars, English cars, Swedish cars, French cars, you name it.
That's right, Molly. Thousands of car owners have taken advantage of Meineke Discount Mufflers prices. So when you need a muffler, check Meineke's low prices. It's easy.
Because chances are there's a Meineke shop near your home. Drive in today.
Installed from 1893. Visit your local independently owned Meineke shop today.
When you buy a foreign car...
I shall take care of your slightest problem immediately.
But when you go back to the dealer with a transmission problem...
You gotta wait, pal. I got 100 cars back there with all kinds of problems.
Bonjour.
Take your transmission problems to AAMCO. We'll have your car back to you fast. AAMCO. Why go anywhere else?
Wilmington, Lynn, Malden, Arlington, Watertown, Somerville, Alston, Norwood, Quincy, and nine others... The Men of AAMCO!
We're pairing now for the championship round, and we've got some good-looking resumes here. First, the challengers, Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman, and now the champions, Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak. So let's get on with it. As we've told you all along, Marcel, a winner twice here on Candlepin Super Bowl, and Barbara Marlowe, a winner twice here on Candlepin Super Bowl. Each of the men going for three. Marcel opens with a strike.
Oh, beautiful.
She has has his habit of walking back from the lane to her seat with a sheepish-looking grin on her face, as if we're supposed to be surprised that she's done that. But of course, we don't buy that anymore. It's even for now, 10 apiece after one. However, Al Josefiak will be filling out that strike momentarily. Spare on the strike. And Bob Bergman takes nine. So they're going to take a run at some bonus money, perhaps. After a couple now, the champions are at 30 plus a ball. And the challengers are at 19. So another mark by Marcel Aiken would be worth $50 in bonus money. I haven't given away any bonus money the last couple of weeks. Week before that, however, he gave away a couple of hundred in bonus money. Barbara Marlowe with a mark now.
Come on! Couple more.
So no bonus money yet. Now, Marcel added three to that spare in the second frame, so it's a 14-pin lead for the champs. After two, she takes 10 here, so it's still a 14-pin lead. It'll shorten up a bit, though, when Bob Bergman finishes off the spare in the third. There you see, there are 29 plus after three. And he adds six. So the lead is 8 pins for Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak after three.
Come on, hammer it!
Here it goes! Bounced in through the kitchen door. A spare in the fourth. Bob takes seven. So here's a look at it after four for the champs, 53 plus, and for the challengers, 42. They're working on a pretty impressive string so far. On the spare, six of them. For another mark. No, just missed the head pin. So we're halfway through. And despite all those marks, it's still close enough. 68 for Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak, and 50 for Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman. Just one or two marks here will get him right back into it in a hurry. The 4, 7, 9, and 10 with some wood to play with, splits it just right, but it doesn't go. Josefiak is one hot bowler. In addition to the match we've got brewing before, he's got a pretty good one going behind us. Bob Bergman's mother-in-law and Al Josefiak's mom are sitting side by side. So after six now, the champs are at 78 plus a ball, and the challengers, Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman, are at 60. Need a mark. And again, not getting very good spare leaves. Now, Marcel on the spare.
All right, that goes.
and 9. So after 7 now, Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak are at 92. Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman are at 70. Neglected to mention, Bob, with a good 10 there, does his bowling at central lanes. He averages 121 there. Al Josefiak bowls at Munson lanes. He averages a 122 there. So we've got two boxes to go and 21 pins to make up if the challengers are going to overtake our champions. Barbara Marlowe has a good shot at spare and needs it, otherwise she can ride off the 10th frame. And she's got it. Good pressure spare here in the 9th.
Three more, Mars.
Add a 7 for Marcel. So right now it's 108 for Aiken and Josefiak and 90 plus for Marlowe and Bergman. And the last thing he wanted, of course.
Come on, Dallas!
Good string for Al Josefiak. A spare in the 10th. He had a spare in the 6th, a spare in the 4th, and a spare in the 2nd. Bob Bergman finishes up with 9. And Al Josefiak finishes off with 16 in the final box for a winning string here of 124. And again, all the pins are important because we might come down to a roll-off at the end of this 8-week series, so you need as many as possible. And Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak got a good share of them. Here are the final totals now for Marcel and Al, a 124 here in the championship string. For Barbara Marlowe and Bob Bergman, a 100. So Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak get another crack at that match bowl thing that they knocked off last week for $100. And we'll be back to see if they can do it twice in a row as soon as we come back in a couple of minutes.
If in all the world you could have only one source of news and information, what would you want it to be? Think about that for a moment. Only one source of news and information. What would you want it to be? If you say Time Magazine, you're by no means alone. You're among more than 29 million people all over the world who read Time to discover how the events of the nation and the world affect them. And not just one week, but every week. Time's lively writing and pictures get to the heart of show business. Sports, medicine, politics, space, and religion. More than 30 regular departments that bring you information, ideas, and entertainment. And now, Time makes an offer so big it can't be ignored. 26 weeks of Time for almost half off the cover price, payable in 3 easy installments of $6.77. So call toll-free 1-800-621-6400. Oh, it almost slipped our minds. With your paid subscription, we'll also send you free the special boxed edition of Time's Desk Reference Library, the Webster Dictionary, Roget's Thesaurus, and the Signet Hammond Atlas of the World. Call toll-free 1-800-621-6400 and get Time for almost half off the cover price. Our operators are standing by. A half year of Time for three easy installments of $6.77. And the Desk Reference Library, all three books, is free.
Well, let's see if Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak can knock off our Match Bowl jackpot twice in 2 weeks. Now, if you want to play along with Marcel and Al, all you have to do here is put your name and address on the back of a postcard and pick a number of pins, anything between 4 and 10. Number 6 seems to be pretty hot right now. And send it off to Match Bowl, care of WCVB-TV, Needham, Massachusetts, 02192. And if you pulled out and if you match with our bowlers, you get to split the amount we have in the jackpot. And that amount this week is 100 because Marcel knocked it off last week. So let's have at it. And a 9. Okay. See if we can match up a 9. Pauline Hopkins of Manchester, New Hampshire wants a 9. Al Josefiak, we'll see if he can come through again. We matched up with 6s last week. No. All right, we don't come close. So finally, we get to add some more money into the Match Bowl kitty, and Marcel will appreciate that. We'll be up to $150 next week in Match Bowl. Now, for Pauline Hopkins of Manchester, New Hampshire, having a card pick alone is worth $25. So next week, in addition to going for $150 in Match Bowl, Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak will go for their third straight win, and the people that will try to knock them off are Gene Wernig of Walpole, Bob Donahue of South Boston, Alice Elliott of East Walpole, and Bill Gaffney of Milton. So I hope you join us. Now, one thing, we might be by with football next week instead of bowling. So check your listings during the week to make sure whether it's going to be the bowling or the football. If it is the bowling, it should be fun because it has been the last few weeks, definitely. Now, for everyone here at Sammy White's, enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
Dristan long-lasting
by Burlington. Fabrics for hang gliding and sailing. Fabrics that make tires stronger. Even fabrics for faraway journeys. All made better by Burlington.
You know, choosing insurance, especially business insurance, can really get you down. So Fireman's Fund suggests someone to give you a lift. Someone who represents several companies, who's free to pick the one with the most for your insurance dollar. Someone with this sign, your independent agent. Take it from Fireman's Fund. You'll never find anyone better to get things off the ground. In the Yellow Pages, Fireman's Fund Insurance Companies.
After a night below freezing, after 3 hours with the lights on, after all these years, people still have more confidence in Sears Die Hard than any other battery in America. All over America. At Sears Tire and Auto Centers, we install confidence. You can count on Sears.
Well, that's a real live look at a real live fighting blue hen of Delaware. And judging by the scene we had today, they almost need an arc to get back to Newark tonight. This has been quite a game as Delaware's won it 17-0 to advance to the finals next week at Wichita Falls, Texas. This is Bill Fleming along with Frank Coyle saying so long from Ruston, Louisiana. Stay tuned next for ABC for part two of American Bandstand, and then at 5 o'clock Eastern, 4 Central, ABC's Wide World of Sports featuring the WBC Super Featherweight Championship fight, Rafael Zuka Limon and Bobby Chacon. That'll be live, plus the WBC Super Bantamweight Championship, Gomez and Pintor, and a report on the Women's World Cup skiing. Travel arrangements made through and a promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United flies more people to Hawaii than any other airline. That's what friendly skies are all about. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.
Saturday, kidnapping leads to a death race with a best friend for T.J. Hooker. And on the love boat, a woman sets out to destroy her competition. And a daughter finds her boyfriend in the arms of her famous mother, Loretta Lynn, on Fantasy Island.
Once again, Channel 5 is honored to be voted New England's Outstanding News. And we're proud to have won more Emmys than any other station. We're just as proud of our individual winners for graphics, directing, set design, editing, videography, hosting, reporting, and performing. As long as our people continue to strive for outstanding individual achievement, Channel 5 will continue to set the precedent for outstanding programming.
As holiday celebrations begin, drunk driving accidents increase. We on Good Day do not want you to become a statistic. Join us on our next edition of Good Day. We begin a three-part series on alcohol awareness. Learn your rights if you're stopped and suspected of drunk driving. And learn how you can discover your own alcohol capacity.
And learn the consequences that you face under the new drunk driving laws. Join Eileen Prose, me, John Willis, and our guest co-host, Tom Kennedy, as we help you have a safe holiday season.
I'm Lee Woolman, and I'm proud to be representing UNICEF. I've seen how effective UNICEF's health, education, and nutrition programs are. But UNICEF relies entirely on voluntary contributions and the sale of cards and stationery. Sending UNICEF cards and stationery is an easy way to help millions of needy children in over 100 countries. Give a child a better tomorrow by helping UNICEF today.
This is WCVB-TV Boston.
We now join regular programming already in progress.
Here we go with the men in their first frames, Gene Gates from Marlboro and Mike Tirio of West Newton. He's working on a spare. Works on it pretty well. He gets 9. Michael does his bowling at Riverside Lanes. He made it here with a 668 in the roll-off, and we've got a double mark. One more mark will be worth $50 in bonus money to Sharon and Michael. So after a couple of frames, Sharon and Michael with 29. Donna and Gene at 18. Now this preliminary round is worth $200 to the winning team and $100 to the losers. The championship round, $250 to the winners, $100 to the losers. However, if it's the fourth week, the winners get $2,000. And that's just what Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak will be bowling for a little bit later on. Sharon needs this for the triple mark. No. Gates and Donna McKay pick up 4 pins, so it's a 10-pin difference now after 3. Bowl, just to keep you up to date, is up to $250. We'll make a bid at that right after our championship string. Now, if you don't have a card, in one of our bins. We'll tell you how to get it there just a little bit later on. Add a 10. Pins, the difference now. Sharon Tierney and Michael Tirio leading Donna McCabe and Gene Gates. All of them. And this could go. So as Michael Tirio slides into position there, he's got a good chance to pull a little bit away here. 57 plus a couple of balls. Donna McCabe and Gene Gates now are at 45. Michael working on the strike. Spare. First mark for Gene Gates and Donna McCabe. Ralph Stewart does a little maintenance work for us. And also checks on that piece of wood down there that's in the way of Michael Tirio. There you see it. It's okay, and he'll have to use it. He just slipped as he was about to let it go. His foot slipped into the gutter, and that's why the ball followed it there. Takes a 9. So after 6 now, Michael and Sharon are at 74, and Gene and Donna, 55 plus a ball. So Donna needs a big fill here. And settles 4-5. 14 pin lead. Oh! Sharon Tierney. For the second straight time, bowls a strike. Oh, all around it, but not right on top of it. So after 7 here, Sharon Tierney and Michael Tirio at 84 plus a couple, and Donna McCabe and Gene Gates at 69. Michael on the strike, double strike worth $50 in bonus money. There it is, $50. And of course, what everyone here is waiting for is a chance at 3 in a row, worth $1,000. As Gene finishes up with 9. So Sharon Tierney steps up with a chance for $1,000. We've done it twice on Candlepin Super Bowl. Merrick Cozen and Tom Olster did it in 74, and Pat Fogarty and Scott Williams in 76. Nothing would be too surprising anymore after witnessing 4 strikes in a row on Candlepin Bowling just a few weeks back. George Raymond, remember, put them together. After 9. Sharon Tierney and Mike Tirio at 127. Gene Gates and Donna McCabe at 88 and add 8 at 96. So it is over, regardless of what happens here in the 10th. So Marcel Aiken and Al Joseffiak, after witnessing all these strikes, must be mumbling to themselves. Three strikes in that string, plus two spares, five marks. So they're going to have to knock off some pretty hot bowlers. They want to cash in on $2,000. Gene Gates takes eight. Now Mike Terrio takes nine. Good string. Mike Terrio and Sharon Tierney finish up with a strong 136. Madonna McCabe and Gene Gates a 104. So the hot bowlers, Mike Terrio and Sharon Tierney, now are in the way of Marcel Aiken and Al Joseffiak, who will be looking for $2,000 as soon as we come back, right after this.
The information in this booklet could change your life. It tells you all about the Craftmatic Automatic Adjustable Living Bed. Hi, this is Bob Braun. And right now, many of you are probably in bed watching television with pillows underneath your head trying to get comfortable. Why do that when with the Craftmatic Automatic Adjustable Bed, you can adjust it to the position you would like to have for watching television, reading in bed, or just getting comfortable so you get the restful good night's sleep that you need for your good health? If you'd like information about this without obligation, let me send you this booklet. It doesn't cost anything except your time. Go to the telephone right now and call this toll-free number, and I'll send this booklet about the Craftmatic Automatic Adjustable Living Bed.
To receive your free booklet by mail, call 1-800-228-1500. That's 1-800-228-1500 toll-free. Call 1-800-228-1500.
Good, out of here.
Hey, Mike, pass the milk.
Coming your way, Gordy.
Nice catch, Gordy.
Rosie, I never miss.
I think you just went into a slump.
Get something quick, Rosie.
Catch this, Gordy. Bounty starts quicker.
Wow.
So you finish quicker.
Hey, you mean only Bounty works that fast, Rosie?
It has to with all the big league bumblers like Gordy around here. Come on, I'll prove it. A top challenger here and Bounty here.
Hey. Bounty starts working a lot quicker.
Like I said, Bounty starts quicker.
So you finish quicker. Gee, that's great.
And now Mike will show us how strong Bounty is.
Huh?
Mike, put that pie on here.
Boy, that is strong. We're convinced, Rosie. Bounty's the champ.
Around here, it's gotta be.
Hey, Rosie, catch.
I never miss.
Ooh.
Bounty's a quicker picker-upper. Starts quicker, so you finish quicker.
Here we go with the championship string now, and here are the challengers fresh off that 136, Sharon Tierney and Mike Terrio. And here are the champions, 3 weeks old, Marcel Aiken and Al Joseffiak, looking for $2,000 should they win here. So, obviously, they're eager enough to get going, and we will. She was practicing, the last ball she rolled was a strike, and she figured she'd quit there, and she almost picked up where she left off.
Catch it!
Opens with a spare. And here's a pretty good-looking 10. So right now, we've got no difference. 10 apiece in the first frame. However, Al Joseffiak will be working on the spare.
Come on.
Another good-looking 10. And 9. So, 5-pin difference after a couple of frames. The champions, Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak at 25, and the challengers are at 20. Sharon Tierney and Mike Thurio. Well, it'll be tough, but that's a spare lead regardless with the wood down there. Let's see if it goes. No. Nope, that'll be 9. And Marcel takes 7, so the challengers get 2 pins closer. After 3, the champs are at 32, and the challengers are at 29. Almost one tremendous stride. Spare. Michael takes a 9, and Al does the same, so no change. 4 boxes into it were separated by just 3 pins. 41-38, the challengers on the downside. And Sharon Tierney's going to have to reset them because we've only got 9 down there. A quick counting, Ralph Stewart was able to pick that out before a ball was thrown. Sharon. Well, now, if she had left that as it was, that would have been a strike. Sharon waiting for some wood to clear. And if it stays there, she'll be fine. It does. For a spare. Still no marks for the challengers. There it is. Marcel needs 10 to keep pace, and she's got it. Still a 3-pin lead. Halfway through, 51-48. Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak up by 3. Now, even should Al and Marcel lose this, they would still have a shot at $2,000 because they would be 3-week winners. Strike for Mike. Now, getting back to the possibilities here. This is the first week of our new 8-week series, so they would then wait out the rest of the series and see if anyone can do better than 3 wins in a row. And if not, they would go into a roll-off for 2,000. So they've always got that in their back pocket. And 9. With 4 boxes to go, the champs have 60, the challengers have 58, but the challengers have a couple of bonus balls. So Sharon added 7 onto the strike. The challengers now lead it by 5. Still a 5-pin lead. Here's a look at the numbers. Sharon Tierney, Mike Tirio at 74. Marcel Aiken, Al Josefiak, 69. And that will be next to impossible to convert. Mike Tirio can hope for a miracle and nothing else here. And he takes 9. Al Josefiak needs as many of these as possible, and that's a pretty good job of it. He gets 8. So there's a 6-pin spread with 2 boxes to go. The challengers are at 83, the champs at 77. There's a big hit by Marcel Aiken. She's got a good shot at spare. Piece of wood down there will give her a little bit more to shoot at. Marcel, a 2-time winner on Candlepin Super Bowl, looking for 3, and she's got a shot now. Well, that's fair. It'll come down to the final box. Just about in a dead heat because of the spare. Here you see the difference now. The challengers on the right side there have 92, and the champs have 87 plus Al Josefiak's first ball. So a fill of 5 or 6 or so would just even this thing up, essentially, and it would come down to the last box. Another split, but that wood's going to stick around and maybe help. This is the big one. Oh! Was it ever the big one? I can't decide whether it was my good fortune or misfortune to have Mrs. Josefiak sitting behind me. As she has been for each of the 4 weeks that Alan has been on. All right, for the conversion, yeah! So he gets the 10. And there's 5. If he puts this one through the middle, we're dead even. If he gets any of these, he wins. Well, I'm sorry, he's already won. Well, that's just the frosting, as we say. Now you're going to get to see Mrs. Josefiak. Yeah, I could be sure of that. She's been waiting to do that for a couple of months now. So Al Josefiak, needing a 5, comes up with a 10, comes up with a strike, and takes it in the 10th frame. What a match worth $2,000. Let's take a look at the final numbers. For Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak, a 116. For Sharon Tierney and Mike Tirio, a 102. And now, while the excitement settles down, we'll take a break and be right back with Match Ball. Hope you stick with us.
Give him a gift that says you thought about him.
Time. Thanks, Dad.
Give her a gift that says you think she's smart.
I can sure use this, Mom.
A gift for those who love the world around them.
Honey, thanks.
A gift that's really from your heart.
This Christmas, let someone know how special they really are by touching their mind with Time magazine. What better way to keep them up with the world and help them understand the news that affects us all? Whether it's startling stories that rock the world or lighter looks at people's lives, you'll be giving a gift of words and pictures that makes the world exciting 52 times a year.
Give him a gift that keeps on giving. Give her a gift that lasts all year long. Give them a gift that says Merry Christmas time after time after time.
Why not flatter someone you love with a full year subscription to Time? They get 52 issues in all, and you get Time's special Christmas rate, just $31. That's almost 20% off the basic subscription rate and 60% off the cover price. And we won't bill you until after the holidays. Call now, and we'll send you this 1983 Time Pocket Diary to put under the tree to announce your gift. Like Time, it'll stay with someone all year long. It's so easy to give Time for Christmas. Just call our toll-free number, 1-800-621-7200.
Give them time to smile, time to learn. Give them time to think and time to dream.
Call 1-800-621-7200.
Merry Christmas.
Get Time for 60% off the cover price.
Merry Christmas.
And get the pocket diary free.
Well, while things are still buzzing about, let's get right on to Match Bowl. It's up to $250 now, and the champions, of course, get the first crack at it. And that means, as we've all heard, Marcel Aiken and Al Josefiak. All right, you need a four or more now. Now, if you don't have your card in one of these bins in front of me, just put your name and address and a number of pins between 4 and 10 on the back of a postcard. Send it off to Match Bowl here at WCVB-TV. Need a mass, 02192. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just enough. She knew it all the time. All right, let's see who gets to play here. Sister Sibylina of Watertown. Sister wants a four. And obviously, Al Josefiak is just a little bit too pumped up to deliver. He gets nine. So, we add $50 next week. Match Bowl will be worth $300. As for Sister Sibylina, $25 for having your cart picked, and we're just about all done. We'll have a whole new crew of people in here next week to shoot down the line for...
Next week at the same time, 12 noon, Don Gillis for the whole crew. Bye-bye, everybody. See you next week when Tony Marie defends her title.